Hello, everyone, and welcome to the latest episode of the Iona Athletics Podcast, your source for all the latest news, happenings, and more from the Iona Athletics program. I'm your host, Mike Phillips. We have a very good episode for you this week. We'll be joined in the studio shortly by our first ever athlete guest on the podcast. That is senior defender Malcolm Moreno from the Iona Gaels men's soccer team. We were talking to Malcolm in just a bit, but we have a lot to recap from last week, so let's dive right into it. We will start out on Monday, September 16th. For the second week in a row, a member of the Iona men's soccer team was named the MAC Rookie of the Week. That honor goes to Ignacio Sanchez, who scored in Iona's 3-0 home opening win against Binghamton back on September 14th. And congratulations to Ignacio Sanchez again for being named the MAC Rookie of the Week. Let's go ahead to Tuesday, September 17th. First little off-the-field news here. Iona basketball season tickets went on sale for the revamped Heinz Center. You can go to our website, www.icgaels.com, for more information on how to get season tickets for Iona Gaels men's and women's basketball. And on the 17th, Iona Golf took part in the Iona UCD Challenge over in Dublin, Ireland. Day one went very well for the Gaels. They took a 2.5 to 1.5 lead over UCD in the first day of the challenge. Let's move ahead to Wednesday, September 18th. Iona men's soccer, tough game on the road, but emerged with a 2-1 victory at Sacred Heart. Lenworth Lopez and Mauro Bravo scored for the Gaels in that one, while Giuliano Santucci had 8 saves in net for Iona. Iona women's soccer, big comeback win at Mazzella Field on Wednesday, coming back to beat St. Francis Brooklyn 3-2. It was the first time the Gaels overcame a 2-goal deficit since October 8, 2010. So first time in almost a decade, Iona women's soccer coming back from 2 goals down to win. And Amber Crispin scored the game winner for Iona that day. Iona golf also in day two of the Iona UCD Challenge. Clean sweep, building a 6.5 to 1.5 lead into the final day on Thursday. And that's where we'll go next on Thursday, September 19th. Iona Golf did recapture the Challenge Cup in resounding fashion. They beat UCD 12-5 as the final. It's the second straight time Iona has won the cup on Irish soil. Congratulations to the Iona Golf team for bringing home the Challenge Cup. Let's go ahead to Friday, September 20th. And Iona Cross Country hosted the 25th annual Brother John Paddy Doyle Meet of Champions. The men's team won their event, 4 runners finishing inside the top 10, and the individual winner, was junior John Millar. It was his first race in the maroon and gold, so a great start to Millar's Iona career, winning the Brother John Paddy Doyle Meet of Champions. Iona women's team finished 10th in that event. Sophie Murphy was Iona's top finisher. She finished 6th place on the women's side of the race. Now let's move ahead to Saturday, September 21st. Men's soccer, another home game against LIU. Big win there. Beat the Sharks 3-2. That game was very busy second half. 3 goals scored after the break. Lenworth Lopez, game-winning goal in the 82nd minute on a penalty kick. And Gabriel Signani had his first start in the goal for Iona and made 2 saves in the victory. Iona Volleyball lost in straight sets at Ryder in their MAC opener. Junior Jamie Smith led Iona and both squads, actually. 13 kills, 2 blocks. She also had 1 of the 2 aces for Iona. And finally, we will go to Sunday, September 22nd. Women's soccer has its MAC opener on the road at Marist. Play to a 1-1 draw. Amber Crispin scored the game-tying goal on a penalty kick late in regulation, and sophomore Emma Havrilla had 3 saves on the 16 shots she faced. Congratulations to Iona's volleyball team as well. They pick up their first win of the year. They will on the road beat St. Peter's in straight sets. Senior Carla Johnson led Iona with 12 kills and a .500 hitting percentage. Iona set new season bests in kills, hitting percentage, assists, and block assists as the first win for volleyball head coach Isai Velez Perez. And last but not least, the Iona men's water polo team was at the Connecticut College Tournament. They went 2-1 on the day. They began the morning with a win at Penn State Barron 15-7. Junior Patrick Hudak had a team-high 4 goals for Iona. And junior Brett Hofer, Lester Machado, helped out as well, 3 goals apiece. The next 2 matches were exhibitions. Iona beat Saddleback 19-10, lost to Cerritos 8-5, and that is your week cap for week episode 3 of Iona's Athletics Podcast. And we'll be joined in the studio by Malcolm Moreno of the Iona men's soccer team in just a moment. We are back here on the Iona Athletics Podcast. Joining me in the studio today, our first ever studio guest, a senior defender for the Iona Gaels men's soccer team. He became a starter in his sophomore year, made the MAC all-academic team 2 years in a row, with an all-MAC second team selection last year. Our first in-studio guest is Malcolm Moreno. Malcolm, welcome to the show. How are you?
Thank you very much for having me here. I'm great. You know, a little bit stress running in between classes and exams, but everything great.
I appreciate you giving us the time. It's much appreciated because you're our first actual athlete on the show. We've had a couple of coaches on before, so
I feel you know, flattered to be the first one.
Yeah, I'm excited to get a chance to talk to you. So I want to start here with what inspired you to come to Iona College? So why Iona everywhere?
When I was looking into schools to come over to the U.S., it was important to be close to a coast and a big city. I grew up in Madrid, obviously a big city, and you know, having Iona, which is a really reputable, not only business school, but also as a men's soccer program, being so close to New York City, to me, was a no-brainer.
Yeah, so this is your last year here. How have you evolved as a player and a leader since when you first got to Iona to where you are today?
Freshman year, got here. It was a team full of seniors. It was like 10, 11 seniors. I was the only freshman that eventually got to play or eventually start. And, you know, I've always been very vocal, but I felt like you know, it was not my time to kind of grab everything. And then as soon as I got older, I got more vocal, tried to, you know, help as much as I could my teammates on and off the field. And then luckily for my senior season, I was selected as captain by Coach Hamilton. And, you know, just trying to ease that transition from high school to college for those first years, and then encouraging those that are already in the team trying to become leaders themselves. Because at the end of the day, we need leaders everywhere, you know?
Yeah, so what did that feel like when Coach Hamilton picked you to be the captain of the squad?
I feel really flattered. I'm not going to lie. You know, it's a great honor for me. I love playing for Iona. I've been here for 4 years. I couldn't imagine myself playing for anywhere else.
Yeah, for sure. And looking back at your time at Iona from when you got here until now, so is there one moment that stuck with you from all your time at Iona? It doesn't have to be on the pitch. It could be off the field. So what is the one moment that stuck with you?
Definitely has to be during my sophomore year. It was the season opener at UConn, ranked nationally, 20, top 25, whatever it was. We got there. They were just expecting to keep on their 8 or 9 year streak of winning their home and season opener, and we completely spoiled the party. Felt great. And yeah, that's something that I'm always definitely going to remember.
You guys have built quite a home field advantage there. I mean, since the start of last year, you guys have defended the home turf very well. So why do you think that you guys play so much better here in New Rochelle in front of the Maroon Maniacs and all the Iona fans?
I think that's the key, to be honest with you. You know, it's not only that it's our field and we practice there every day and we know the measures and everything, but it's also the energy that the people that are in their stands give to us. You know, it's vital for us to feel energized by all of those that are on the stands. And when we translate that into our game, and I think that our record shows it pretty well.
Yeah, I mean, I saw something like you guys were 8-1-1 your last home match. 10 home matches is great. And you guys rode that home field advantage last year into the postseason. So what was that feeling like as you guys realized, you know, we're going to the MAC, we're going to post the playoff game? What was that feeling like in the locker room?
To us, it was huge because it was also the very first time that the men's soccer team were to host a playoff game. And for us, it was a great opportunity to showcase how good we were as a team and, you know, eventually make history and try and bring a championship to Iona. Unfortunately, it couldn't be done, but we're looking forward to doing at least, you know, the same this year.
Yeah, obviously, you guys had a nice mark last year. You got to that home playoff game at home. You guys want to get back to this year, probably get a little further. So you guys are done wrapping up the non-conference slate, starting to get ready for conference play. How has that non-conference portion of your schedule helped you guys get ready for the conference season in order to build on what you accomplished last year?
I think the coaching staff has scheduled those games pretty well, pretty smartly. There were 7 games. We still have a couple more to play. And they allowed us to get tested against difficult teams. We went up to Vermont. We played against nationally ranked St. John's. And those are challenges that you want to have. You know, they're not games that you're supposed to go and win. They're games that you're supposed to go and you're the underdog. And it forces us to get better give everything that we have for whenever we get into the MAC, be able to have gotten that competitive edge as well as the relationships between us on the field.
Yeah, and you guys won at Vermont, played St. John's very close. So obviously a good start here, a good build to the season. I'm very excited to see what happens with you guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
And my last question for you guys is out for you, obviously. You're an integral part of this team, but obviously there's more to you than just what you do on the pitch and what you do on the field. So can you tell us about some of the stuff you're up to off the pitch and what you want to do after you graduate here?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, this summer, as I was recovering from a knee injury, I was also interning in the city for a nonprofit, which is called Skip, and we were based at the New York City technology campus for Microsoft. It was great. I'm really into business. I'm a major in finance, and I would like to pursue a career in the financial industry or a consulting industry afterwards if I don't go pro, because I know the coaching staff would like to see me playing pro, so you never know. The future is the future. I'm not really thinking about it too much right now, but the plans are there.
Yeah, so you have the plans laid out, but ideally, if you got the chance to play pro soccer, you'd take it.
I want to say yes.
Well, there you have it, folks. Malcolm Moreno, senior defender on the Iona soccer team, first in-studio guest on the Iona Athletics podcast. Malcolm, thanks for all the time today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
All right, that was Malcolm Moreno. Be sure to check out the full interview on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/ICGaels. Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. The weekend comes, my cycle humps, ready to race to you. All right, it's time to take a look ahead to the upcoming week at Iona Athletics. It's a little light on games this week, but we do have the exciting Meet the Coaches event coming up on Thursday, September 26th, from 7 to 9 p.m. at the Yale Club in New York City. Come on down, meet all the coaches from your Iona Gaels athletic teams. For more information, check out our website, www.icgaels.com. Now let's move ahead to the upcoming week of action. On Friday, September 27th, the men's rugby team will be on the road. They will be at Fordham. Again, men's rugby at Fordham on Friday, September 27th. We move ahead to Saturday, September 28th. The Iona volleyball team, its first home match of the season against Canisius at 1 o'clock p.m. Just a note out there for anyone looking to attend this game. The Heinz Center renovations are still ongoing, so this match will not be played on campus. It'll be held at nearby Monroe College in downtown New Rochelle. For directions to Monroe College, check out our website again, www.icgaels.com. You can look out that information in our composite calendar section. We will have a link there to directions to Monroe College. And the women's soccer team is on the road, a conference matchup against Niagara. Sunday, September 29th, we move ahead there. The volleyball team, another home match, this time against Niagara. That will also be at Monroe College. Again, go to our website, www.icgaels.com, for full directions on how to get to Monroe College. And for all game times and sites, be sure to visit our website, www.icgaels.com. Be sure to follow our social media handles. Again, that is at icgaels across all major social media platforms. That's all we have for you this week on episode number 3 of the Iona Athletics podcast. Our next episode comes out on Monday. Until then, keep fighting the good fight, Gael Nation.